In this video, I'm going to show you how to get rid of knee pain with a butter knife. It literally is magic. Stay tuned. Hey everyone, Dr. Rowe here at SpineCare in St. Joseph, Michigan. So me personally, I deal with chronic knee pain from an old high school football injury in which I had a meniscal tear and ended up, having surgery on it. And I wanted to share this technique with you because it's so easy to do and it just takes a butter knife. It's going to help break up adhesions around the knee, give a lot of pain relief. So if you have an arthritic knee, a locked up knee, tight muscles, you name it, this is going to be a very safe and easy way to be able to go in there and get more motion back in the knee and hopefully get a lot less pain. So let's get started with it. So in this video, I'm going to be using an everyday butter knife. I like ones that have a little bit more thickness to it, and also this one has a little bit more of a round angle. I think those work a little bit better, especially to get in there and just get those muscle adhesions out. So I hope you have a butter knife laying around. If not, go to the store, pick one up, and get one that has just a little bit more thickness to it and a nice round edge. Also, what I'm going to be using is coconut oil. You can use pretty much any lotion, especially muscle or massage oils, that will just help lubricate the area that you're going over. It's very important to have a lot of lubrication for this so you're not pulling out hairs or causing discomfort. So just as fair warning, you're going to have to forgive me for my hairy legs. That was just how I was made. So let's start off by putting some massage oil or any lubricant right over here over the top part of the leg. When it comes to the lubrication, a little bit more is always better. It's always better to have more than less, because we don't want to pull out any hairs or anything like that. So I like to sit in a chair or at a ledge where I'm going to be able to move my knee up and down freely. This is important because we're going to attack these muscles at different angles, and we want to put a little bit more motion into it while we do it to get a little bit better of a result. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that thick edge of the butter knife, and whatever you do, don't use the serrated part of the butter knife on this. That should be common sense. And we're going to start over the quadriceps right here at the top of the leg. What I'm going to do is put it at about a 45-30 degree angle, and I'm going to start to slowly start to work my way down towards that kneecap. Just go very slowly with it. In a healthy muscle, this should glide very, very easily. And if you start to feel like there's a lot of grittiness, that's that adhesions that we're going to focus on here in a bit. So a healthy, nice muscle should feel very smooth while you do this. But once you start to go over these ligaments and tendons and you start to feel a grit, that's where we're going to stop and then just slowly build into that area. And what you're going to notice is a lot of redness will start to come out. You see how this area right here is starting to get very red? What it's doing is it's bringing blood flow into the area, and it's going to help with the healing of that soft tissue. So I like to work over a spot of grittiness for about 30 seconds. I'll just keep going down on it just like this. And then after that 30 seconds, I'm going to attack it the other way. So really just get in there, put some pressure, and strip that muscle. Think of it as like tenderizing that meat of your leg. And just keep working over it for about 30 seconds. Again, if you're starting to see a lot of redness, that's just blood flow. That's how this is supposed to work. It's going to bring a lot into there and just help get these muscles feeling a lot better. So what you can also do next is take the round edge of the butter knife and start to go around the kneecap. Just really get in there and dig and find certain spots that need it. Go on the outside of the knee right here. Just dig and go at that 30 to 40 degree angle, and then also make sure to go inside too. Work around the kneecap. Really explore the area, and any spot that stands out as being gritty, just really tight and achy, dig in there. Get that tension out. So what we're also going to want to focus on while we do this is an active range of motion. So while I do this, I will also then start to move the knee up and down to really target that muscle. And if you really start to feel that in a certain motion, hey, this is really painful, hold it right there, dig in there for 30 seconds, come at it at a different angle, and just keep going through all those motions. You're also going to want to focus below the kneecap and just dig in there. So this is just a really good technique to be able to go in there and work those ligaments, tendons, muscles, explore the area, and strip those adhesions out of the knee, which will hopefully give you more range of motion and hopefully give you a lot less pain. So just give it a try.
So after we're finished, we need to focus on putting a little bit more range of motion into those ligaments, tendons, and muscles around the knee. It'll give a little bit better of a result. So just do a simple knee to the chest. Grab right here and just bring that knee up towards the chest. What I also like to do is put my hand behind my knee right here and just do some light kicks with it. It just puts a little bit more motion in there. And that's what we're really focused on, getting more flexibility into the knee. And there's no substitute for good stretches. And then the last thing that you're going to want to do if you are having a lot of redness over the knee here is just put an ice pack over that area that you really digged at. Just put it on there for 10 to 15 minutes, and then at that point, it should help bring down some redness.
So if you got a lot of relief, please show us your support by giving this video a like and maybe subscribing to our channel too. If you have any comments or questions, or maybe have a suggestion for a future video of ours, please leave it below in the comments section. We appreciate it, and thank you for watching.